Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but we all friends now. Isn't that the most beautiful testament to God's love for us all?
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, you little pair of shits!
Let's go! That fella looks angry!
Stop, you shit!
Shit went that way.
Thanks for the help, friend.
You know, I kind of missed old Bob Taylor.
I don't bounce around so much.
Come on! Keep up!
Remember when they had
the
break?
Hey! Moron!
Half of them up.
This is fun, mister. I like you.
What's the problem, friend?
Give me my thanks, boy.
What are you talking about? You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just want to speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He been mighty disrespected. Now, get out of here.
Hey, folks.
Good morning.
Disembark here for the market, folks. Anyone from the market district? Disembark here for the market, folks.
Hey, y'all.
Good morning, sir.
Jesus, you idiots are welcome to each other.
Well, I never.
You. You're annoying me.
You don't mean that, do you?
Where did you folks meet? The freak show?
Well, the cheek.
You know, up.
I'm talking.
This is gonna sting!
Where you been?
Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John. You meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less, the swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way east of land we know, and far from real open country.
There you are.
You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much. Just see some slick little greasy-haired European. Clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up the place, boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, we're gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm them. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John? I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen.
Run along now, boy.
Was that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax. You looking for my brother? I got this.
In peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per Picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have.
Now,
we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business.
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words. You lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Ti adoro. Fate da beresti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
No, no, no. So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in this cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course they run a mile. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, well, you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute.
What?
Ugh. All right, let's go.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know,
yes.
You did good. Holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom.
Good thing everyone
for all the money we cost him. Must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right. Ah! Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead.
What the hell, Morgan?
This way. Stupid mutt, get out of here. Come on, let's keep on him. I'm gonna check over here.
Sorry, I had a bit to drink. A friend died. They can hear us, you know. They're still with us.
You should get out of here, mister. It ain't safe. Someplace.
Okay, but we'll need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time. Think there might be something in here.
Get out of here. Damn, the law's here. Come on, let's see if that gate's open. Locked. Let's just track back to where we came in.
Damn it.
Come on. We best stick to the side.
Come on.
coming. Hide.
Hello?
What's up?
Looks fresh. Hey. And I forgot my sandwich in the microwave when I left. Good Lord, hang on.
Stick with me.
To Dutch.
Okay, fellas. Looks like we lost them for now. Come on. Let's just get there. Get this done.
Bounce, wow, wow.
Well, you took your time.
Where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time.
I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend. Thank Mr. Look. Bronte. For everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
You know, Arthur, Mrs. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys.
Let's go, boy.
Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it. Get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What? What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte teach me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs. One for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time. But I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like you wouldn't know.
You had a nice night then? Most enjoyable. Well, the man's an intolerable blowhard, but he stocks a fine bar. How did you fellers get on? Any problems?
A whole heap of them. We about doubled the population of that graveyard.
You know, I thought I heard gunshots, but the gramophone was playing.
Unbelievable.
Each to their strengths, Arthur.
Now I'm back. Sorry about that.
What are you doing?
You're good.
I went in there with a
Bro, I want a fucking fat ass burger right now.
I went mine a burger myself.
Yeah, we're having steak tonight.
Okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
Well,
we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys! We got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Boy, safe, thank goodness.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says.
Damn, my vape's still charging. What the fuck? Alright, I'll be right back. Mike. Michael, wait. So, my microwave almost just caught on fire.
I just got back on the mic, so... I don't know what the fuck this is, but it was in the microwave when I tried making a fucking sandwich. What about it? Can you hear me good? Like... Oh, it was probably just because of the microwave. Or... No, a chicken sandwich. A chicken sandwich. You look like you got dropped on your head when you were a kid. Don't knock that over, Gizmo. So I'm in the very first big town. Yeah. The living room. It's around. Really? Yeah. I literally, I can see my TV, dude. Like the living room and the kitchen are two or one room, pretty much. So I don't see why. Damn, that shit hot. I cannot believe the fucking microwave almost caught on fire. I'm fucking bitching at somebody, whoever the fuck left that in there, because that was uncalled for. Leaving it on the counter as well. Sons of a bitch. Alright. I'm gonna play, but eat at the same time. That's what I like about this game, because you can take bites when there's a cutscene.
Take what?
You can eat while there's cutscenes.
I didn't know that.
No, you can...
Oh, wait a minute. You mean like while you're riding or something? Right?
You can eat in real life while you're watching cutscenes.
You can do that with any game, can't you?
Yeah, but this game is a lot better. Because it's Red Dead.
Shut up, Hammer.
Bro, this game's so good.
It is good.
And grab me a fucking beer. Where's the beer at, guys? Zelito.
Good to have you back, Jackie. We missed you.
Castillo. Lágrimas vine llorando.
Okay, this Mexican has a soothing voice.
Do what?
You must be starving, son. Let me get you something to eat.
Thanks, Mama. Can I play a little?
I said that Mexican has a soothing voice when he sings.
Which one?
I don't know what his name is.
Yes, we did.
Thank God. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Okay,
where's my bed at so I can sleep and do a mission? I can't find my fucking bed.
Dear boy, Tahiti. If you say so. Mangoes, maidens, paradise, an unspoiled paradise. Yeah, I hope so. Faith, Arthur, have a little faith.
I for real can't find my fucking bed. Hold on. What the hell? Where'd y'all put it?
What do you mean you can't find your bed?
I can't. I'm trying to go to sleep because we're celebrating.
Are you in the mansion?
Yeah.
Are you upstairs?
It's upstairs.
Dumbass.
I didn't know. Thought it was outside. Why am I this?
No, guy? You're in Jose's room, boy.
Somebody was here. Ugh. Damn, my room's all fucking set up. I like this. Holy fuck.
Wait a minute, what is that? Oh hell, that's a witness. And they is running. Oh hell no.
Oh hell no.
It was self-defense, you bastard!
Ain't no self-defense back then. If you shot somebody, you did.
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie's thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life, and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur, I have made such a mess of my life, time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Couldn't you change and be a man? Put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment. Life is very confusing, and I see now that I'm not very good at it. I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess. It's not my fault, but I need your help.
Oh, you need my help again?
I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint Denis. Oh, Arthur, I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else, and for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
You know how to shoot up in, straight in the air, don't you?
If I shoot up straight up in the air, it'll come down and kill me.
No, won't it, Hammer? Good Lord. Do you, wait, when you're aiming... No, I'm asking, do you know how to shoot straight in the air?
No.
When you're aiming, hit up on the D-pad and your gun will like be pointed upwards.
Oh.
Yeah. That would be pretty funny, though, is if the bullet did come back down and hit you, but... No, it's not like that.
Time to go, boy. So what do you think of this place?
You folks sure move around a lot.
Should I go help Mary Linton? Yeah, buddy. Where are you going? Okay, I gotta see what the upgrades are up in this bitch. I have $2,000, might as well do something with it. Where the fuck's the money at? Is it upstairs?
What do you mean, where's the money at?
Like, not the money, but...
The contribution box?
Yeah.
It's downstairs in that room, like, right when you walk in the door, it's on the...
No, it's upstairs. Ledger. Let's see what we can buy here.
Why you gotta go and make things so complicated?
Whoa! Some shit like that.
Acting like it's someone else gets me so frustrated.
Frustrated. I don't fucking know this song.
You fall and you then something, something turn it into. I don't know it either. So that those two parts. You take what you get. Turn it into. I hated that song with a passion.
Good morning, Arthur.
Hello, Mary Beth.
How are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
Well, I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run with
now you. Now I know.
We're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem.
A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along.
Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Shit, I'm going with the fucking fat lady.
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going.
Get going.
All right, head for Rhodes. And quick.
She's in Rhodes?
No. She's at a place called Bradley's House, just west of there.
How do you know?
When we first got here, she told me she was worried that our camp was near a safe house that gang she ran with used from time to time.
And you told Dutch?
No. She spoke to me in confidence. I suppose I didn't think it would be a problem.
Now it is.
Oh, yes.
What do they want with her anyway? I think I saw one of the foremans hassling her and Valentine.
Yes. They probably followed us down here. You don't know what happened? She killed one of them, for good reason, but clearly they don't see it that way.
Tilly?
Yes. Young Tilly Jackson isn't as sweet and innocent as you might think. But like I say, she was defending herself. She fled and fell in with us right after that. I just hope we can get to her in time.
It's not too far.
If they've touched a single hair on that girl's head, I will eviscerate the sons of bitches. Anyway, talking of folks disappearing, have you seen that boy Kieran since the party for Jack? Okay, I think that's the place up ahead.
I think there's a guard.
I'll deal with him.
What you want?
Kind sir, we're lost and in need of some help.
Don't get out of here.
Oh, I see that kindly face of yours. And I know that for the right inducement, a gentleman such as yourself could be mighty kind.
Now get out of here.
Oh, now you keep saying that. You don't mean nothing by it.
I said...
You said your last word. Well, what are you waiting for?
Shit! What the hell you think you're doing?
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
No!
Well,
thank fucking damn it!
There they are!
Come on!
Grab that gun! Anyone approaches, shoot them!
Oh, don't worry, I'll be just fine.
Fuck this fucking now, bounty hunter area. Son of a bitch, kiss my ass. Suck my dick.
Alright, get after them!
Yep.
There.
Oh, $150. That could have went to somebody I'd...
back to Tilly so we can all have a nice little chat. I'm gonna head over there now to check she's okay.
With pleasure.
I'll take his horse. He won't be.
This could get bumpy.
Do you have the first idea what you're getting into?
I'm Anthony Foreman.
Well, thanks for the introduction, Anthony. Is that Foreman with an E? I want the Undertaker to spell it right.
Funny bastard.
Shut the hell up.
Get off me, funny bastard. Who are you running with?
She didn't tell you?
She didn't tell me nothing. Oh. This rope is cutting into me.
Don't feel so good when you're the one tied up, does it?
She killed my goddamn cousin.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be seeing him soon enough.
What are you gonna do with me?
I ain't sure yet. Reckon I'll let Tilly decide what you deserve.
You're wasting your time with that girl,
coward.
Go to hell. You're... All right, damn it.
Here's your man.
Bring him here. Dump him on the ground here. I want to get a good look at this monster.
So he's still alive then?
Yes.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ate yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat. Go on. Finish.
All right, you.
Come on. Let's get you home. Yeah.
I spared this guy's life. Am I a good man, Mike?
Sure. Shh. Hang on. I did. Damn it, Bill.
school girl. Yep.
Oh, ho, ho. It is badass. Fuck, thanks for giving me like 3 seconds to get... Emery, is your mic muted?
No.
Okay.
This is not for me.
Nor me. But we're alive. Sean's not. Jenny. Matt.
You're in a good mood.
Enjoy it while you're alive. Just happy to have the boy back safe.
Nobody ever.
Actually, I'll come back to you later,
Morgan.
Okay?
I've jotted down a few things that I think could be a nice addition to right here.
Maybe it would be...
all stay together.
You know. Damn it, these people have no fucking chill. Wyatt changed out my shotgun, but it did.
Look around you. Ain't nothing normal about
that.
I reckon I'm gonna think about it. Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
This is going in the pot. Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Hey, Arthur. What you want? Yep.
Go get me some fucking alligator.
Can you wrestle an alligator?
Yeah, walk up behind it.
I need to find one first. Didn't know how hard it is to find a fucking alligator in a swamp. Oh, fuck you, Mike. You son of a bitch. I should have ran up behind that bitch and pressed circle and nothing happened. Now I'm dead.
I gotta have a little bit of fun. Oh.
Fuck you.
Oh, that's funny.
It's not, man.
It is, though.
God damn it, man. I lost my fucking hat because of you.
You can get it back on with your horse.
That is true.
Oh, I wish I could have seen it happen.
Go back and watch my fucking broadcast.
Is anybody watching you right now?
No.
Oh, man, I wish somebody was. That would have been funny. You should save that clip. Like, if you can record both of our voices, like, that should be some iFunny type crap right there. Where is he coming from? Why am I dying instantly? Oh, I'm not dying. The darn Indian's dying. Okay. Good joke. Cherokee outlaw ass out of here.
Get some fucking bait from these birds and go hunt a fucking bear. Straight up shot a turtle and that bitch is just moving around. Like, fuck you, you didn't hurt me at all.
The turtle or one of those alligator snapping turtles?
Yeah, alligator snapping turtles.
Gotcha. I saw a frog earlier.
Got me a baby gator. Damn, this son of a bitch is heavy. Okay, fuck this turtle. Get off of my fucking horse. I want this gator on there. No. I'm in dangerous alligator territory.
I like the fact that you can pick up any hat you find off the ground.
Yeah. You don't have any gun oil? The fuck? That's where I have a lot. Oh shit, I got a gator chasing me! The shit that I do. Bro, I need my horse to get over here. I need to grab this fucking shotgun off of him. About time I have a fucking rifle. Shooting these big ass fucking gators with a goddamn pistol. Like, I ain't getting very far with that. I fucking shot this gator straight in the fucking nose and he did not even die. Oh, that's like a warning shot. I get it now. The up on the D-pad. What the fuck is my other horse doing way the fuck over there in the water? Yes, sir. Let's kill the gator.
Yeah, there's a home to go back to.
When you're carrying an alligator skin, your day just fucking alligator. Fucking country.
Woo! Yeah. Were you able to get a clean kill on it, or is it in poor condition?
Poor.
I thought so. I don't know how to get it in a clean condition.
I think I do.
How's that?
I just straight up dropped my alligator skin.
Uh-huh.
Fucking did Deadeye and shot him in the eye from the side, and he straight up dropped.
Oh, let's see if that did it.
Yeah, I'm skinning him right now. Nope. Still poor. I should have blew the fucking... Oh my god.
What the fuck? Dutch, really? Okay. Okay. Okay.
How do you get perfect alligator skin?
I don't know.
Maybe you have to shoot him straight in the fucking head?
You know, no, I done that and I still got poor. You know, I recently unlocked the Deadeye portion that shows fatal areas. So maybe I'll go back with a bow and arrow and see if I can do it now. But we'll see. It's getting good now, my boy. Oh my gosh.
Is it?
Oh yeah.
Camp could do with a few improvements. Why don't you take a look at my ideas? Who makes this crap? Keep my eye out for some good material. With the goddamn Philippines. Just make sure it goes into the pot, not your pot. What even are the Philippines? Okay then. Many thanks.
It's enough to turn a good, honest fella to drink. Being a bad, dishonest fella, it's gonna send me to drink twice as fast.
going on, everybody, and welcome back to another Red Dead Redemption 2 guide. In this one, I'm going to be showing you guys how you can collect perfect animal hides. Now, the perfect animal hides are what are going to be used to craft special items, and on top of that, they're going to get you a lot more money. So, there's different things that you guys need to know about hunting in order to collect the perfect animal hides. So to get started, I'm going to let you guys know about the different types of animals that you guys will be hunting, and how to know if you can get a perfect hide from them at all. So the first thing to know when hunting is, you need to pull out your binoculars whenever you find the animal that you want to kill, whether it's going to be a squirrel, a rabbit, snake, or even just one of these deer like I'm going after now. The first thing that you want to do is pull out your binoculars. Now when you zoom into an animal, it doesn't really matter what type it is, you can hit the info button. Now once you get the info on the animal, it will tell you to use a certain type of weapon for a clean kill. Now on top of that, you want to take a look at the bottom right hand corner of your screen and look at the stars next to the animal that you're looking at. If you have a 3-star animal there, that means you can get a perfect hide from it, and after receiving the info, you will know which kind of weapon you will need to kill that animal. So only 3-star animals can drop the perfect pelts, and you will need to find out which type of weapon you're going to need to kill that animal with. So for this deer here, it says to use a long scoped rifle in order to get a clean kill. Now anything less than a clean kill will actually damage the hide, and so you don't want to waste your shots. You really want to take your time when going for a perfect hide. So take your time to figure out which type of weapon you need to use, what type of bullet, and then actually shoot the animal in the proper spot. You will completely damage the hide and won't be able to use it or sell it for as much money. So head to your horse and get the equipment that you're going to need in order to take out whichever animal you're hunting. Certain smaller animals will take a varmint.
Oh, what a fucking Mr. Know-it-all. Did you hear what he was saying?
No, hang on.
I just got bit by a fucking snake.
Really? They run away from me. Suck the venom out.
I couldn't. I had to eat fucking a plant. But, did you hear what that guy was saying?
No.
When you're hunting an animal, you have to take out your binoculars and then study the animal. And if you look at the bottom right, it has to be a 3-star. In order to get perfect pelt.
What do you mean 3-star?
Like a 3-star animal. Like, if you take out your binoculars and aim it at an animal.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pretty stupid. I think you should be able to get perfect pelt from any type of star animal. And it'll say what type of rifle you have to kill him with. Come on, you fucking horse. Taking forever. Found him. Found the perfect alligator.
That goes for you.
I lost him. He straight up dipped into the sea. If my fucking horse will come to me. Though I can't really kill him because my horse won't fucking come to me. Is this a long rifle? What do I got? Long scope rifle, so come here, horsey. Are you fucking joking? I just killed a fucking alligator. I was walking towards it. Fucking alligator comes up behind me and bites me in the ass, and now I'm dead.
Oh, yeah. I probably should have warned you. I didn't think to. I honestly did not think to warn you. But a lot of times, they'll come in a swarm at you.
Okay. I'm done hunting fucking gators.
No, you're not.
For now.
No! No, trigger! Trigger! No! 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 Bastards! You bastards! You killed him!
They actually killed him?
They killed my horse! Hang on. Wait. Revive. Can I revive? Oh my gosh, Hammer. Oh my gosh, my heart was just... Oh my gosh, Hammer, you don't understand how sad I almost got. Like, this is my horse, man! Oh my gosh. It's like I walked into an ambush of mountain people and it's... It's okay, though. I need to buy some more stuff to give him, though, in case it happens again. Just rest, boy. Take it slow. Take it slow. You're a good horse.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh yeah. Old friend.
Oh my gosh, Hammer. No, I was for real tearing up for a second.
Old Senor Bronte, that horrendous snake has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we get you a gown.
Is that sad?
Yes.
How is it sad?
What?
That I was tearing up over my horse possibly being dead.
It is sad. It's a game.
Shut him.
We are ridiculous. Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I. if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There can be fine pickets.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca. I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen. This way, please, gentlemen. Senior Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Signor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know, Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know, respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Signor Bronte.
Come.
We'll meet you out in the balcony when you're done.
I hate how in first person he walks so much faster than the other characters.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I wouldn't know. I haven't played first person.
Oh, I was just in first person. I want to... Look at this house. This house is fucking huge.
Ah, the angry cowboys, you arrived. And you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something. Although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Senor Bronte.
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me. Like that one. See that wretch? He's the mayor. Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. I mean, hero, they say, but this is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things, yes, but a young wife is unseemly. Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, and a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you... As a guest? Yes. As my guest? Bah! Do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
Sì.
I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint-Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves. Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing. Unless it's information. Of course, Jose, you will find us some place to run.
I should have been paying attention. I have no idea what the mayor looks like.
By the water fountain.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. What say you and me cool off?
Get your hands off me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down. Count to 1,000.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. Rider?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
Oh, my lord, they're fantastic.
Excuse me, father. Excuse me, father. Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come in and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Did he say something about Cornwall? Yes, we'll find out what. Sure.
Just what is your problem?
Bonjour, monsieur. Beautiful.
I am.
Sir.
Oh. Hey there, mister.
How do you do?
No problems?
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good. Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Turner.
Hey.
the telephone. It keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later.
Marie! Find that little reprobate Jip and beat him! I will not have standards slip in this house! Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look at me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. Standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight.
Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting.
Waste of time.
Maybe not.
Arthur? Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find now?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of it. Big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on. Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home!
Oh, I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk are so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it. Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions. See how the law react.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear.
But that's you.
You're almost heading home.
Where is home?
Son of a bitch.
Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
My vape has juice where it shouldn't be. Fuck, man. I'll be back. My fucking tank just like fucking spilt juice everywhere.
Cool. Yeah, that's cool.
Alright, I'm gonna move my PlayStation back into my room.
Okay.
Alright. Save the game.
Bye-bye, 4K.
Right. Nah, this game looks really good on 4K, though.
The name of the mission I'm about to do is called Red Dead Redemption.
Red Dead Redemption.
You know, it's the game.
I know.
So I think this, like, I think I just, okay.
Everybody's starting to get off work.